Huntsville City Schools is one step closer to fixing its financial issues. Tonight, the board approved a budget that will hopefully get them out of a major budget shortfall. Our Rebecca Petit has the details. Rebecca?
Connor, the budget that the Huntsville City School Board approved tonight will get them closer to the $18 million in reserves that they're required to have, but it by no means means they're in the clear.
Huntsville City Schools is in recovery mode. It's working to get itself out of a financial crisis. This budget would increase the general fund balance by $1.8 million.
The projected balance in this budget is exactly what you see on that bottom line right there. It's $15,272,292.37.
This budget is still around $3 million short of the $18 million in reserves the district is required to have. So what's the district's game plan?
We have got to really look at attrition. And I'm just saying, we need to look at if we need to right now put a freeze on hiring. Because we have some tough times ahead of us, and as much as we don't want to cut programs, as much as we don't want to eliminate positions, we got to take a hard look at the fact that we don't have the money.
This budget keeps teacher pay raises. The district maintains it will not be letting go any of its teachers, but cuts to support staff are inevitable.
My goal is to protect the classroom and the teachers because they are the most valuable resource. So we're looking at all avenues, whether through attrition, looking at the central office staff first and foremost, because we are the support mechanism.
The finance director for the city of Huntsville did make some corrections to the initial budget proposal.
We do owe the city for closing costs on a bond, so I went and put that in here so you'd see that as well. So that increase has brought the total debt service to $30,066,267.36.
The amendment from the city did not change the bottom line.
The district will now send the approved budget to the state board. Putting the Valley first, Rebecca Petit, WCDX News.
Thank you, Rebecca.